The universe is vast and full of mystery. And one that has been puzzling astronomers for a while now is fast radio bursts. And I mean, I get it. How am I supposed to make this thing go fast? Or burst?
Nope.
Luckily, I have an astronomer waiting for me in an elevator to explain it all in the time it takes to go up to the top and back down again. Let's go. Hey, Manisha.
Hi, Rad.
So I know we're talking space, we're talking astronomy, we're talking fast radio bursts.
That is correct.
All right, let's get into it. What is a fast radio burst?
Fast radio bursts, or FRBs as we refer to them, are these extremely energetic flashes in the sky that last about 100 times quicker than the blink of an eye. However, they're invisible to the naked eye because they emit at the range of colors outside what the human eye can perceive.
Okay, but where do they come from?
Now, the furthest known FRB was produced 8 billion years ago. And in comparison, our solar system is only 4.6 billion years old. This means that when the light left the source, we did not exist. So
okay.
The solar system, the Earth, life on Earth, humans, we all came about while the signal was traveling to us.
But wait, you said that it was light, but it's not light, it's radio waves.
It's radio light, so it's
not okay.
The visible part of the spectrum that you can see, but they're outside the red
yes.
to blue rainbow colors.
Okay, but what caused them? Could it be
the
aliens?
It is not aliens, I can tell you that. We know of about 50 theories for what these could be, but the current leading favorite are magnetars. So these are these extremely energetic objects which have massive and powerful magnetic fields.
So what are the implications of FRBs? Like, why do they matter?
What's interesting is the signal bears the imprint of the medium that it travels through. So the FRB encodes information about everything in its path. So as a result, the radio data are a goldmine of information. And this, in fact, helped us locate the missing matter in the universe.
What do you mean missing matter?
So 95% of the universe is dark energy and dark matter, and 5% is normal matter. But 50% of this normal matter is only accounted for, and the remaining 50% was considered missing until very recently.
How is it missing? How can we just not know where it is? It's matter.
So in a sense, it's invisible because it doesn't emit or glow or absorb light, but it does slow down radio waves, which is where FRBs come in.
Have we found all of it?
We have found all of it, so it's
That's
consistent
cool.
with what we theorize, but we don't know how it's distributed.
There's always a but.
There's always a but. That's what research is.
Well, thank you for teaching me about FRBs. So let me start with what we do know. Fast radio bursts are bursts of extremely energetic radio waves. Think FM radio, but way, way bigger. And we kind of know where they come from. We have observed at least once that they come from magnetars, which are a type of neutron star. But other than that, we don't know what produces them. The other reason why they're really interesting is we can use these fast radio bursts to give us information about matter in the universe. And the way that we do that is by comparing long and short wave bursts that come from the same origin point and calculate how long it takes for them to arrive at us. Now, when they pass through matter, that's going to slow them down, and depending on the material, it'll slow them down by a different amount. So we basically can look at all of that and figure out what's out there. And in doing this, we have managed to find a whole lot of matter that we just thought was missing, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna be thinking about that every time I listen to the radio now. Hey there, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, you can see more elevator pitch here, or you could subscribe below for more videos from ABC Science. And if you're keen to uncover more cosmological mysteries, then stream Catalyst on ABC iView.